On a day when Ed Miliband announced that Labour would cut public spending to reduce the deficit, Shadow Chancellor Ed Balls came to Hove to find out how small businesses in the city are faring. In the process, he got a lesson in the art of roasting beans and then making the perfect cup of coffee. So how would Labour give a much-needed pick-me-up to Brighton and Hove's small business community?
We need to make sure that we nurture and support our small businesses, because some of them will expand and grow and be the large companies of the future. Others of them will carry on doing a great service for local communities and creating loads and loads of jobs. Lots of people are saying, though, business rates have been too high, so we're not going to go ahead with the big cut in the corporation tax rate for large companies. We're going to cut and freeze business rates for small companies. We're going to make it easier for small companies to take on apprenticeships. We're going to make sure that they get the support they need from local councils. But if local councils see business rates go up, that money will be kept locally. That's the way to make sure that the voice of small businesses is heard and that councils respond and do the right thing.
His words seem to go down well with small batch employees.
He was keen on sorting out business rates, which I know are often a problem for us and other small businesses. He's keen on helping out with the apprenticeship schemes. We're going to be doing an apprenticeship scheme next year, but he's keen for government to get more involved in that, which is really fantastic.
But whatever their plans for businesses, with both Labour and the Tories committing to cutting public services to reduce the deficit, doesn't that make the Greens, who oppose cutting public services, a strong alternative for voters in the forthcoming general election?
Yeah, well, look, it's always very easy for Green politicians in Westminster to say that they're going to resist all cuts. I think the proof of the pudding's in the eating. When you've had a Green council here in Brighton, as far as I can see, it's not gone so well. When you look at refuse collection, when you look at green and recycling issues, the Green council, as I understand it, had a pretty bad record. Maybe that tells you that Greens aren't so good at these things. They can't quite deliver when it comes to actual policy and decision making.
The battle to be the next government has officially begun. Flemmich Webb, latest TV news.